Visualizing all sentient beings filling space vast as the sky. For the sake of all of them, I will receive these Mahati teachings, these Dzogchen teachings. Are there some who were not here yesterday? Kashi Tiring Tangbo Lepso. Rela. So there's also a number of nuns that weren't able to be with us yesterday because they had government paperwork they had to accomplish. They're sitting outside. We couldn't fit everyone in so that they may hear him. He's going to do a review of yesterday and use the microphone. Come for Dharma teachings. It's necessary to understand the meaning, to take it to heart. Then like that. The three roots. When you come to Dharma teachings, if you don't hear them well, it's one of the difficulties. The other difficulty, if you don't understand the meaning of the words with your mind, what's being got at, even though you hear it, without understanding the words, it doesn't go in. And the third is, if you're afflicted with a lot of pride and desire and things like that, where you think you already have it and don't need to get it, then you also don't understand the teachings. So these are the three hindrances to receiving teachings. Then there are six prerequisites.
If
you have too much pride, if you're caught in pride, then you end up thinking too much, worrying, disagreeing with it, putting your own ideas in it from pride. So even though you hear the Dharma, you have to have desire without doubt. You have to hear it as it is and be free of doubt of it. Sometimes from pride there will be doubt arising. Also, distraction can be a problem. If your mind is wandering around outside somewhere thinking of all the other things, then you will not understand and take the teachings to heart. Also, if the teachings go on too long and you just get dull-minded and you just sort of space out on it, that's another hindrance. The meaning of it. You have to know you understand it. What it is here. To understand the words, but not the meaning. To understand the meaning, but not the words. You need to put aside both of those, also your preconceptions. So these are the five hindrances, the six hindrances, and the three hindrances that occur in hearing Dharma that should be set aside. We're all practitioners here. When people meditate, it's important to have your body in the right position. This is very beneficial. This will cause a great benefit to come. There are, in positions, we have seven different aspects of the position of body that is necessary to know. What these are? To know how to put your body. Put your left foot in your right, on your right thigh. And your right foot on your left thigh. Bring your hands together just below your navel. Leave them below your navel, right upon left, there in your lap. Your back, your body itself must be held completely straight. You have to have it with your arms curved, relaxed, and your chin hooked. You need your chin tipped down slightly, and also your neck hooked, shoulders relaxed, and back. You don't need to do anything fancy with your tongue. Leave it right where it lands behind your front teeth. Your gaze should follow the line of your nose outward and down. When you meditate, these seven positions of body. This is how it is done. This has great benefit, placing the body in this position. It's necessary that practitioners know this. The translator, the great translator Marpa, he said, from putting the body in the in a position with the five aspects, the body being straight, the body held straight, the neck hooked, these are necessary. Keeping you straight, tucking. With your neck down like this. In the Vajra position of your legs, your robes tucked holding you stable like a mountain. Stable like a mountain from this. Using a meditation sash to also support you nicely so that you have the stability of a mountain. You're supposed to support you with your clothes, your seat, your pillows, a meditation sash so that you can relax without falling over. This is how the body is to be put. These are the five points.
points. As a result of my 5 points of body position, if you do it well, all your airs, your chi, will gather into the central channel, the uma. All of it will gather there in the central channel quite naturally. There, the fire of tumo from below the navel, it will burn upwards naturally without forcing. There, from the crown chakra, the life force essence of mind will drip downward naturally. And you will need not have to reject or do anything to your thoughts. The innately natural state of tingenzi will arise spontaneously. And the gone beyond of wisdom. From the 5 points of physical position, the 5 nyonten knowings, wisdoms will arise. So sit yourself down in a vajra position.
There's
a pratyeka Buddha out in the forest meditating there. A monkey came and saw him. The monkey, he copied his position. The monkey, he watched the Pratyeka Buddha meditating in a good vajra position, and he copied the position. The monkey's thoughts, they all spontaneously dissolved into the direct meditation of tingenzi. The body itself can cause this. You need to know this is importance. When you meditate, you need to know this well. When you meditate in Maha Mudra or Maha Adi, Dzogchen or Dzogchen, when you meditate in the Madhyamika way, when you meditate on the gone beyond of wisdom of the 6th paramita, in all of these instances, it is important that you put your body in the proper position. Yesterday, I also explained to you how you need to leave your mind alone. Your own mind, you need to leave it in a relaxed state. Leave it relaxed, your mind. Don't poke it. Without being distracted by all the many things in this universe, without attempting to concentrate by holding the mind still forcefully inside, if you can avoid these two extremes, you can go beyond the thought and conceptualization process.
And there,
when you relax beyond thought, in that total state of well-being where nothing is forced, in that state of relaxed openness, shatter your mental creations with a fierce and forceful pet. Sudden, fierce, and sharp, emma ho. What this is, it must be fierce, it must be sudden, it must be short. When you do it like this, all your thoughts, all of the subtle creations that your mind makes of itself are burst. So this pet, what it is, the letter of wisdom, the letter of method, pa, the letter of wisdom, tra, brought together, spell the seed syllable. So you strike with a seed syllable, which is the combination of method and wisdom. Having struck with pet, You are looking at your mind, and your mind is not making something of itself. You are not looking at what you think your mind is, you are looking at mind itself. Beyond thoughts and utter and open blankness. This
hetewa
is without boundaries. Your own awareness, the awareness, rigpa, it is not constricted. It sees through everything, past everything, for nothing obscures or obstructs it. This is indescribable and inconceivable. This Dharmakaya awareness is. Recognize it. Recognize this for what it is. Yesterday, I spoke of this a little bit. The view of meditation. I spoke to you of it, and some of you have knowing from yesterday. Dharmakaya awareness it is. When we say Dharmakaya, you need to look at your own mind to see this. In the not seeing of anything at all, emptiness Dharmakaya is. The awareness, the awake awareness, this which is alive and unobscured. Each of you must recognize it yourselves directly, perceptually. Then, having seen it, you will know. This is the first vital point, the recognizing of this. Then, to speak of meditation. It is simply this root as explained to view. It is simply to return your attention from its distractions to this. Then, both in the arisings and in the not arisings, when you have experiences such as anger, all of the different arisings that occur in mind, for example, you get emotions of desire, you get emotions of joy and sorrow. All of these, the likings and dislikings. You know, if something good happens and you're happy about it, or you get sick and you're sad about it. Therefore, at all times and on all occasions, when you're going around, sitting, whatever you're doing, your mind's innately natural awareness, you need to recognize it. In recognizing this, Dharmakaya awareness is. This awareness of the view, this view which is itself aware, recognize this. This natural state of mind's luminous clarity is innate in each individual, each living being. This innate always was, always will be Buddha nature. We call the mother luminosity of ground. Then, when the teacher gives you the pointing out of the essence, telling you where to look, this is the child luminosity of path. In this way, this luminosity, indescribable awake awareness, in the direct seeing of that as your awareness leave it so. Again and again, as experiences of bliss, clarity, and non-thought arise. You know, you get body bliss states. If you meditate a lot, your body gets that way. You hardly even know, don't even know if you have a body. You think, goodness, do I have a body or not? Nothing hurts. This is called a bliss state. Or an experience of clarity. And you think, this is it, I've got it now. You're actually lying to yourself, even though you've attained an experience of clarity and wisdom. Oh, so easy to lie and think you've got it here. Or a thought-free state, where you're tranced out. Long time you sit. Thoughts. They're gone. That's what happens. This is a thought-free state, a thought-free experience. These are a bit in your way. They are a bit of the obscuration of the true meditation. This bliss state, if you get yourself caught up in it, attached to it, born among the gods of desire you are. The state of wisdom and clarity, if you like that one, gods of form, and the thought-free state, there where nothing happens, just like empty sky it is. Get yourself born there for eons, formless realms. That's why you want to break through these mind-made meditative experiences. By breaking through these and looking at your mind, the innate and natural awakeness will manifest so that you are able to perceive it, whether sitting or going about. And you will find no difference in this free, immaculate awareness, whether you are sitting or going about. No difference between meditation and session, between session and break. That's session, when you sit there in your seat in the proper position practicing. Your session break is when you get up and go about and do things. No difference occurs. They are the same. For always mind in its natural place. However, until this happens to you, until the true stability occurs naturally, until the unforced natural state of stability is there, it will help you to throw aside your distractions and to focus your attention on meditation. It aids a yogi to make sessions in his meditation. So you do make sessions. But you don't always only meditate while in session. At all times, while going about and while sitting down, you continue your practice. Rest yourself continuously in the natural Dharmakaya awareness. Recognize that there is nothing other than this. To decide on one single thing, to rest in this state of recognition and decide to go for it, that is the second vital point. Now I have spoken of you in the root text of view and meditation. However, you will find that whether you are happy or sad, whether things, circumstances you like come to pass or circumstances you dislike come to pass. You know, favorable conditions and you like them. Sickness or poverty and you don't like it. These thoughts, as you see them arising again and again, so you see them freed in their arising. You need to recognize the natural awareness of mind in the arising of the thoughts that arise from circumstance. In this recognition, they lose their power over you. In this recognition, your thoughts no longer pull you here and there. So recognize your thoughts, all of them, in their arising from and as Dharmakaya. For example, like writing on water. When you write on water, you cannot make a mark there. In the moment of creating the mark is released. Self-arising, self-liberating, instantaneously. Self-arising, self-liberating without duration. Unceasing, self-occurring, self-liberation, in which way whatever occurs is food for the empty and naked awareness. Whatever thought arises is but the playful expression of the awareness of the Dharmakaya. When you see this, perceive this, recognize this deeply. When you recognize that your thoughts are nothing other than this, directly seeing it as so, then they are all traceless and naturally free. Ah, wow. Alala in Tibetan is oh wow in English. The way third thoughts arise, it's the same as before. You're still thinking. That's the same. You have thoughts. It's the way they are freed that is the special key. Without this, meditation is a path of confusion. Recognizing Dharmakaya nature in all the arising, seeing how thoughts are no thing, liberated into no thing, then even not meditation is the uncultivated state of the Dharmakaya. To gain this utter certainty in the nature of mind, this utter certainty in the spontaneous and instantaneous liberation of all thoughts, that in the arising they are empty, in the dispersing they are empty, arising and dispersing as emptiness to emptiness. To know this with utter certainty by your own experience is the third vital point.
Sopa.
It is this certainty that comes from experience and practice. This is the third vital point.
This
is your root text. View, meditation, and action, the three. are all contained in the awareness of the view. And the meditation is the meditation of the combination of knowledge and open-hearted compassion. Aided by the general actions of the sons of the victorious ones, all Buddhas, if all Buddhas of the three times, now, future, and past, if they were to confer together, they would find no oral teaching more powerful than this one. This is the Dharmakaya awareness treasure revealed from the Dharmakaya awareness itself. This is discovered as the wisdom of meditation. Unlike treasures of earth and stone, this meditation is unlike that, for it is not impermanent. Gold, you spend it. Useful around here, but you spend it and it's gone. No permanent benefit. All stuff is like that. This is the testament of Gerub Dorji. His testament that he gave to his disciple, the great teacher Jhampal Shini. Heart essence of the three lineages. This is the heart essence of the three lineages, which he just named in Tibetan and which I do not know the English for. This is entrusted with secrecy to the heart children. It is profound of my heart. This is the life force, the heart drops of my heart. My own heart. This is the meaning of the meditation. Meaning of this, do not let it fade away. Do not leave it lying around as if it had no value. Do not let yourself in for further suffering. Take this to heart and practice. This is the teachings of the great Shri Jalpo as well. The Dharma of Shri Jalpo, who's another name for Patro Rinpoche. This lineage has passed down through Patro Rinpoche, Shri Jalpo. May it come to pass in the hearts who are receiving it now. Essence of the Dharma, this. There is nothing greater than.
Now,
the root text I have now been over with you. Now, a beginning to enter into the commentary. The beginning, as always, begins with prostration to the root teacher, Lord of matchless compassion.